Hi, everybody, and thanks for joining us in this first-round matchup of the National Invitation Tournament. Let's see how this matchup unfolds between the Oregon Ducks and the Syracuse Orange. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Hey, when you're putting together your starting five, you don't always need to put your five most talented players out there. What you want are the kids who are going to come out of the gate with a kind of intensity you want to set the tone for the game.
All 10 players are set, and now for the 10. Syracuse snaps up the tip, and they bring it up the floor. Now they work it around the perimeter with a little baby hook.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. There's a double team waiting there. With the J. Can't get the shot to go. Controlling the ball. Feed the low post. He pulls up with a jumper. Jumper won't go. Goes up for two. Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
And a momentary look from three-point land. From downtown. Doesn't go.
Nice hops.
Watch your head, young fella.
Out on the wing. Goes up with it. Missed it. They work the perimeter. For two. Got it. The Ducks did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
With the J, plus the jumper. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Number four takes the feed. In the lane, the missed shot. Dick, how do these guys stay so fresh on defense?
Hey, three words, Brad. Rotation, rotation, and rotation. They're playing like a true team out there, supporting one another when there's a breakdown.
Loose ball, kept in. Number 12, slowly performance has just gotten in his head.
He needs to take a deep breath, refocus, and get after it.
Trying to pack it inside.
And the fans love it. Jump with joy, fan. Hey, that's my guy, he's yelling.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Gave it up. He puts up the three ball. He's going to see this guy to sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living the nightmare, Brad.
The jumper. Nope. Number 24 handles the pass. Pushes it up. Picked out of the air.
He saw that developing.
He was right there when the ball left his hand. A little two-man action. goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. He gets the bucket to fall. Pushes it up. Puts up the J. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Drains the shot. That was a great delivery on the back cut, Dick.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
Try to go inside.
From the corner, perfectly executed. Jumper nails the J. Pushes it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
Down in the low block, trying to work inside for the bucket. Knocks it down. Out on the wing. He shoots from downtown.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They're working around the arc.
There's the trap.
Off the mark. And we've got a change in possession here. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Right now, gotta focus defensively.
He gets the bucket. On the outside. He shoots the jumper. Jumper won't go. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nessler. Horrible shot selection.
Looking for a good shot. For two. Off the glass and no good. He gets it to go. On the outside. Goes up with a shot. Off the mark. Makes it. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if he were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
Working it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Nails the jumper. Looking for a good shot. From the corner. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Here's a double team.
That's basic.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Top of the circle.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. They work it around the perimeter. And they come with a double team to stop it. Can't connect. Number one gets the ball. Pushes it up. Jumper. Bust the J. You can just blink and this guy's already got 20 on you. This man is a scorer.
Hey, one way or another, this young man creates ways to score. He's on from the moment he laces up his shoes. Wow, what hops, baby. What hops.
Cross court. He tries to knock down the three. He misses the J. Buries it home. Cross court. Top of the circle.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Pushes it up. There's a double team waiting there.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. On the left side. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. On the left side. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries a three. Busts the jumper. Dumps it in. For the bucket. He shows the sweet touch. They move it into the front court. Cross court. Blocks the shot.
Nice rotation over blocking that shot. I love it when teams help one another. It's not a one-man game defensively. You got to help your teammate out. You got to rotate over.
Takes a medium-range jumper. Scorches the net with a J.
Up and inside.
The rejection. I don't think gets up to make the block. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Dick and Brad, I'm sure you can hear and see Coach yelling from the sidelines. He wants the team to start forcing the issue on offense. In his opinion, the tempo needs to increase. Based on his team's personnel and his coaching philosophy, I guess he feels that this will give his team a better chance at getting the win. Guys,
thanks, EA, our third member, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Nice rejection.
The last line of defense is a good block.
Misses from in close. Goes up for two. Gets it to go. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Nope. Gave it up.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Tries for two. He gets the shot to fall. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Nails a sweet jumper. We've got a timeout. More ESPN coverage of the NCAA coming up right after this. Back to the action now to half court. Let's see what they set up, Dick.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. In and out.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Out on the wing. Cross court.
Great anticipation defensively.
The Orange in transition. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Gets it to fall. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Now they work it around the perimeter. Number one picks up the foul. First personal foul. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
Why just doing his thing? I'll tell you, Brad, just a great, great performance. I love this kid. He's a PTP-er, baby.
They'll throw this one in from the side. He puts up the J. My goodness, Dick, have you ever seen such poor shooting before?
I tell you, horrific, awful, terrible, poor, appalling. I'm absolutely embarrassed, Brad.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy, too much mustard there.
Pushes it up. Tries the three ball. The shot won't fall. Number 32 gets the ball. And a momentary look from three-point land. We're at the five-minute mark. Here comes the ball screen. On the dribble, gives it up. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. Goes up with it.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Knocked it down. What are some of the things that up-tempo teams will look to do, Dick?
Up-tempo teams typically have some great athletes, people that can really get out in transition, who really can run exceptionally well, and also can jump exceptionally well.
Cross court. We're at the 4 minute mark. The shooting guard gets the pass. They work the perimeter.
Set that screen away.
Great block shot. He can't get the hoop to fall. They'll work it around the arc.
Is that high screen? I want to use that high screen. Good jump out. Get over the top. That's how you want to defend that, get over the top of that screen.
On the outside for two. He comes up empty. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
3 minutes left on the game clock. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. They get that rejected. Gave it up. Scores it. Number 32 gets the pass. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. Number 12 gets the ball. He blocks the shot. Turnaround jumper. You betcha. Takes it strong to the hoop.
He has all the tools to play down low. He can put a lot of pressure on the defense.
Looking for a good shot. From left of the circle. Can't connect. On the outside. Tries for two. He couldn't get it to fall. Pushes it up. For the bucket. He misses it. Shot clock is dead. For two. There was no doubt about that one. Missed the jumper. At halftime, the Ducks trail by five. Syracuse is killing the opposition on the glass in the first half.
Hey, these kids know what it takes to win big games, Brad. If you can win the rebounding battle on any given night, you have a great shot of winning the ball game.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Looking to move it around the perimeter. With the jumper. Nails the J. Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. That's good. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. It's no good. two-man action. He tries the jumper and come up short. In the paint. And the ball is saved. Great job. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Inside. He makes the block.
Nope.
For the bucket. He makes the shot. The power forward with the ball. For two. He hits it. Didn't look like anything was going to keep him from the basket there, Dick.
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
Off the mark. Pushes it up. Puts up the J. Jumper won't go. There's been nearly perfect defense so far out there tonight, Dick.
I can't imagine any complaints from the coaching staff.
He can't get around the trap.
Well done. Great trap.
No good. He's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Number three takes the feed. Goes up for two. That was nice.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive a coach bananas. Hope you don't lose your hair.
Tries for two. Nails the jumper. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Feed the low post with the J. Missed it. The bucket. Can't put it down. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Puts up the jumper. Knocks it down. They go into the low block. For two, can't connect. Ten to shoot. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Cross court. He goes for three. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
He shoots from the deep corner. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
Wow, are they struggling, Brad? With a capital S. I don't think any of them are concentrating right now.
In and out. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Spacing.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. The Orange now looking for a basket in transition on the left side. He takes the shot and score it. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Tries for two. Drains it. Dick, what can they do to stop their scoring barrage?
I don't know, Brad. Dim the lights, maybe? I don't know. They're on fire right now.
From the corner. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
For the bucket. Scorches the net. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Coach has been very animated over here on the sidelines. His team is doing a great job of following strategy and playing that up-tempo style. I'm sure he'll continue to encourage them over the course of the game to ensure they don't stray away from what's working.
Erin Andrews, our sideline correspondent, all of you know that, with an additional insight there. They'll throw it in from the side. Pushes it up. For two. He drains the shot. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. Players got a much-needed breather with that timeout. On the left side. Goes up. Nails the J. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Off the mark. Pushes it up. Wants a three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
He goes up with it. Nope. On the dribble, gives it up. It's knocked away. Great block. The Orange looking to attack in transition. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on a defensive end. Just for excitement with that jam.
They go with the entry pass. Out of the post. Turnaround jumper. Nice pass to the low block. Gets the J to fall.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He takes a three. They got it. moving it around the perimeter. Turnover by the senior.
Up and inside.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The small forward with the ball. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. On the left side. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Tickles a twine.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He attempts the jump shot and come up short. Now they work it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Trying to go inside.
For two. Nice shot. Trying to feed the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. Off the mark. Cross court. He looks for three. And a momentary look from three-point land. He bombs from outside. Gave it up. Goes up with it. Nails the sweet jumper. The Ducks did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball into the high post puts pressure on the defense.
He swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
They work the perimeter. Goes up for two. Number one with the ball. About 7 minutes remaining. Number 33 gets the pass. Outside jumper. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Time to pick up the defense here now. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
They work it around the arc. From way outside. Can't connect. Pushes it up. Tries for two. Oh, yes. The Ducks did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
On the outside. Launches the three. Missed it. On the left side.
Wow, look at him rotate over.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior. Jumping didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Pressure that basketball.
Here comes the ball screen. For two, it sticks. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The man can't escape.
Are you kidding me? He tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Brad.
On the left side. And now the fadeaway jumper. The missed shot. Looking for a good shot. Attempts the trifecta. Jumper won't go. On the outside. Jumper. Nope. Pushes it up. Pushing in transition. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
We're at the 4-minute mark. Gave it up. The Start the Bus moment is brought to you by State Farm. Off the mark. Takes the jumper. A severe offensive drop for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Takes the shot. And come up short. And he can't hit the shot. Buried it.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Working it around the perimeter. We're at the 3-minute mark. Out on the wing. Down inside, goes up for two. He missed. Inside.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
Tries for two. They get it to go. Looking for a good shot. That's not a good pass. Dick, I've heard you talk about this a million times before. How about the number of baskets that have been scored in the paint here?
Hey, the points in the paint have been huge for them, Brad. Winning the battle in the paint will win you games. It's obvious that that's where they're looking to attack.
Inbound from the baseline. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Number 32 steals the ball. For the bucket, he buries it.
Look at that spacing.
He launches a three. Off the mark. On the right side. For two. Off the glass and no good. Off the glass and no good. Out on the wing. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. on the dribble, gives it up. He throws it up from downtown. Missed the jumper. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Jumper can't connect. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Unloads a three.
They're going to find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Great hustle. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Now let's see what they do with the inbounds play on the baseline. We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Kicks it out.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Gave it up,